guys, so today I'm going to talk about one of my favorite art forms, which is in the verge of extinction, Mathani Pacheri. Mathani Pacheri is an ancient traditional art of painting images of god and goddesses on a piece of cloth. It is found in the temples of Gujarat, India. Animated image of god, goddesses, devotees, flora, fauna is painted in a narrative story. The term Mathani Pacheri is derived from Gujarati language, which just means behind goddess. This art form originated when the nomadic Vaghari community in Gujarat were barred from entering the temple. They decided to make their own shrines with depiction of goddess in different form. The unique feature about this temple hanging is that 4 or 5 pieces together form one shrine of the temple. Traditionally, this rectangular fabric was used as a canopy or the ceiling for the nomadic shrine. This rectangular fabric is divided into 7 to 9 columns to narrate and interpret a story from the Puranas. This art form is also called as the Kalamkari of Gujarat. Basically, a bamboo stick is used as a kalam or a pen. The bamboo stick is sharpened to draw the outlines. For painting, the same bamboo stick is cut in a way to form paint brushes to fill in the colors. And hand blocks are used to define the borders. The organic cotton is destarched, basically soaked in water for 24 hours. This fabric is then dipped into a mixture of hardap paste, which is tamarind seed powder and water. Then this fabric is sun-dried. When the fabric is dry, the sketch of the goddess or the mata is hand-drawn on the center of the cloth, followed by intricate pattern around the fabric. All the outlines are hand-drawn using a bamboo kalam in black. The black is prepared by a mixture of jaggery, iron scraps, and tamarind seed powder. The gaps are filled with red color. It is prepared by heating a mixture of alum, tamarind seed powder with water. The fabric looks like yellow with black outlined figures. This fabric is then sun-dried. The dried fabric is then boiled with Algerian powder. It's a yellow powder that is prepared from the root of a madder plant. This powder reacts with the alum and gives out the red. Tavra fool or axle wood is added to the mixture when it reaches the boiling point and is checked in intervals so that it maintains the white color where the fabric is not painted. The cloth is washed in fresh flowing water and directly dried under sunlight. This helps the process of bleaching and drying. The only downfall to this art form is that the work completely stops in the rainy season due to the damp and wet weather. The three basic colors that are used in this art form is red, white, and black. Red is the color of blood or rakt. White is the color of purity and the connection to the ancestral spirits. Black repels malevolent spirits and intensifies spiritual energy. Let's move on to the modern day approach that the artisans are using in the changing time. It takes a lot of patience to do this traditional folk art. For example, a 5 feet by 9 feet fabric will take more than 2 to 2.5 months to finish. Strong and bold use of colors show the power and energy in the god and goddesses. Now, the artists have moved on to more artistic and illustrative designs, but the depiction of these mythical characters and the style still remains the same. The artists have started incorporating more colors like yellow, green, and blue, but the age-old technique of extracting colors from natural materials still remains the same. In this changing times, the artists are using their skills to make smaller souvenirs like wall hangings, teapots, scarves, trolls, etc. using modern and new motifs. While the craftsmen are refining their art to suit the changing times, the sanctity of this religious art form has remained same and untouched. These crafts have remained true in spreading the glory of Mother Goddess and the wonderful art. The reason why I chose this traditional art form is that the dye is naturally sourced, which helps in reducing the water pollution and is a very sustainable option as well. Supporting this art form will provide employment to the artisans, as it's a very labor-intensive work. Let's acknowledge our artisans and let's promote this art form globally. I hope the content of this channel adds value to your life. To know more about the art artisan, please read the description below. Like, share, and subscribe. Stay humble, be kind, and make a difference.